My name is Sandra Lemire, and I'm an author of 5 books, and I would like to introduce you to each of them. They have a story, and there's a beginning of my first book, Form, Function, and Fancy. I wrote this, published it in 1994. I actually started writing it in 1982. So there's a lot of years goes into the preparation before you actually go to press on a book. My next book is Yorkies Head to Tail. And this book actually was written by request. The publisher of this book had read my first book and wanted me to write this particular book. He wanted it to be the Yorkie Bible for anybody who's ever gotten a Yorkie puppy or a Yorkie in their life, or even a small dog, and didn't have a clue what to do about it, how to take care of it, what does it need, all of the ins and outs, the thousands of questions that come up. And he already knew what I knew, so he said, I want a book that just speaks to everything you need to know, Yorkies head to tail. In 2012, I came out with E-Girls, Entrepreneurial Women. This is a book I spent 40 years putting the work together and rewriting it. This was the second edition, but the first published edition. And this book is written specifically to help women of all ages, but don't let the secret out, men love it. This is a book that every man who reads it, he's the one who's gonna give me the review, because he knows what his wife, his daughters, his children, people in his life, and questions that he never knew who to go ask. And all of a sudden, he's got a place that the answers are in this book. And it starts from the beginning, going back to 1965, when women had no rights, we had no credit, we had no authority, we had to have our husband's permission for everything. And it takes us all the way through the evolution of bringing ourselves into full power, full authority to start our own businesses, and how to find out the answers to questions that nobody really wants to take the time to tell you. The third edition of E-Girls, Entrepreneurial Women, the revised edition. This one was just released this last year in 2019. This one, I went back and fine-tuned everything I had learned about in this one and needed to include in this revised version. Because as years go by, laws change, the IRS changes, the state laws change, technology changes, fads, strategies, all of those things are in flux all the time. And so this book needed to come out to bring everything full circle to what I had learned in the last 40 years. And it is a fabulous book. The funny thing about this book is, in fact, both of these books, whether it's a man reading the book or whether it's a woman reading the book, every lesson that I demonstrate in these books works for either gender, male or female, husband or wife, father or son. It does not matter. The lessons are across the board beneficial to whoever the reader is. So that makes it really pretty neat if you know that I'm not addressing any one particular audience. I want the entire audience to read this book. And if it doesn't have answers for them, it may have answers for someone they love. So I've really enjoyed this book, and I'm very excited about it. It's a hot number, I'm telling you. It will have answers to questions you never even thought you needed to ask. My last book, and one that was, if not the most difficult book, maybe the one I'm the most proud of, is a memoir. The title is, If Only I Could Read My Mind. I said that 1,000 times writing this book, if only I could read my mind. And the subtitle of this book is The Battle to Reinvent Myself. that is a special gift that Dr. Crago, who's right on this street here, has an office here for many, many years. He spent 5 years teaching me what that meant, to reinvent myself. And there are many people who have situations in their life, traumas, injuries, illnesses, all kinds of things that change their life so dramatically that they actually have to kind of start over. And that's what I did, and he taught me how to do that. And so I've wanted to share this with so many people who may benefit from learning the how and the why that you need to do that. You know, one of the things that I get asked, because I've been writing since 1982, so, and you can see I'm pretty prolific. I write a lot of articles and stories and, you know, funny things and tragic things and all kinds of things. And people, when they find out I'm a writer and I've been writing for so long, I'm a great grandmother, and they ask me, they say, oh, I wish I could write. My answer to them and to you, if you're a writer in your heart, if that's what you want to do, maybe not today or tomorrow, maybe way down the road, you've got it in your heart to write your story or write somebody else's story or just write stories. My advice is, and this is to everyone, start writing everything down. Start commemorating all these wonderful things, joy, sadness, laughter, tears, meeting people, odd things, hysterical things. How does it make you feel at the time, right at that moment? You need to commemorate that. I wish all of you happy writing. Thank you.